Welcome to Navigating the Cancer Maze. I'm your host, Grace Gawler. Did you know that June is Cancer Immunotherapy Month in the USA? Well, today on Navigating the Cancer Maze, my guest, Dr. Jill O'Donnell Tormey, PhD, who's CEO and Director of Scientific Affairs at the Cancer Research Institute, is going to tell us a bit about immunotherapies. The Cancer Research Institute was established in 1953 and it's the world's only non-profit organisation dedicated exclusively to transforming cancer patient care by advancing scientific efforts to develop new and effective immune system-based strategies to prevent, diagnose, treat and eventually cure all cancers. Guided by a world-renowned scientific advisory council, including three Nobel laureates and 26 members of the Academy of Sciences, CRI has invested $263 million in support of research conducted by immunologists and tumour immunologists at the world's leading medical centres and universities, and has contributed to many of the scientific advances that demonstrate the potential for immunotherapy to change the face of cancer treatment. Welcome to the show, Jill O'Donnell Tormey.
Hi, Grace. Thanks very much for having me on.
It's really great to have you, Jill. I know you've had a late night and probably a very early morning. Can you tell our listeners about the role that cancerresearch.org plays in the community and in the medical community as well as the public?
Well, the Cancer Research Institute has been around for more than 60 years, and we're a source of support for research in the area of cancer immunology. So we have been a proponent of this field and a leader in the field, really supporting basic research right through translational and now clinical research in helping to develop cancer immunotherapies. So we're basically a very well-known entity among the medical community and the research community, and now that we're seeing some real breakthrough coming through in treating patients with cancer immunotherapy, we're working to really increase our awareness among that population too.
That sounds like a really great job. I'm thinking I'm 60 years old, so you've been around in this organisation as long as I have been on this planet. Can you describe the recent history of the immune system's role in cancer? This is a very big one for cancer patients. If you could talk about where we've come from with immunology, where we are now, and where we're going to with the future of immune therapies.
Well, I think it all starts with the understanding of how the immune system works and what its interaction is with cancer. So over these 60 years, this is the research we have been supporting in understanding how the immune system works. And we all know that we have an immune system, and it protects us against outside threats, such as infectious diseases and